One thing is for certain, that the hour is near. Allah says, what do you know? Perhaps the hour is near. Yet again Allah says, the day of reckoning draws close. Yet again Allah says, Qiyamah has come close and the moon has split. But in spite of these constant reminders of the Quran, you and I, we live a life of disobedience, we live a life of sin. He sallallahu alayhi wasallam said that the day of judgment will not take place until a mother, she will give birth to a master. The hadith is in Muslim. Isn't this the case today? What do you find? You find the son and the daughter, when their mother has carried them in her stomach for 9 months, and when this child is born and he reaches a mature age, the Muslims, they have gone to such an extent that they will call their own mother a dog, to such an extent that they will try to beat their own mother. How truthful is the hadith of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam? He sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, the hour will not take place until killing will be on the increase. The hadith is in Bukhari. Isn't this the case today? He sallallahu alaihi wasallam said that the day of judgment will not come until children of fornication will be big in number, will be large in number. The hadith is in Tabrani. Isn't this the case today? He sallallahu alaihi wasallam said that the day of judgment will not take place until trust becomes the means of making profit. Isn't this the case today? Just as a brother rented his house out to a certain person and he trusted this person. The guy told him, don't come to my house because my wife covers up. I will meet you in the local park. So the brother agreed. And when the brother agreed, time passes, months went by, the payment was on time. But one day, the payment didn't come through. So he tried his utmost best to get in contact with this guy. But what happened? There was no contact with him. So this brother went down his house, his own house that he was renting out. And when he went to his house, you know what did he see? He seen his house was transformed into a marijuana factory. How truthful is the hadith of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam? The hadith is in Tirmizi. He sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, the day of judgment will not come until earthquakes will be on the increase. The hadith is in Bukhari. He sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, the day of judgment will not come until singing women, dancing women, musical instruments will be on the increase and will become popular. The hadith is in Tirmizi. Isn't this the case today? He sallallahu alaihi wasallam said that the day of judgment, it will not come until people will follow the Quran and they will reject the hadith. The hadith is in Abu Dawood. Isn't this the case today? Because when you meet these brothers who only follow the Quran and they say, we don't believe in no hadith, there's no such thing as a hadith, and you tell them to offer the salah, they will say, prove it to me from the Quran. Where does it say you read your salah? How do you perform it? You know, salah in the Quran is referring to horse racing. We don't believe in salah. We're not going to pray salah. This salah where Allah is mentioning over 76 times. Over 76 times. These brothers are saying that we don't believe in the Quran regarding salah. This means horse racing. He sallallahu alaihi wasallam said that the day of judgment will not come until you will see people, they will disobey their mothers in such a manner that they have never ever been disobeyed. But in spite of these constant reminders, in spite of these minor signs, you and I, we still live a life of disobedience, we live a life of sin. And when the people are told that repent before it's too late, they make a joking, they make a joke out of it. He sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said that the hour will not take place until intoxication will be on the increase. Isn't this the case today? These constant reminders, yet we live a life of disobedience, we live a life of sin. He sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said that after the minor signs, the major signs will take place. And after the major signs, the hour will come. I ask, did you know a day will come that a child will try to behead his own father? I ask, did you know a day will come that a mother of two, she will take her daughters, Muslims, she will take her daughters clubbing. And when she is asked, where is your husband? And she will reply by saying that he is on a taxi job. I ask, did you know a day will come that a child, the age of 11, he will return home one day and he will rape his own two little sisters and he will say, I've learned this in school. I ask, did you know a day will come that they'll have a homosexual imam and there'll be homosexuals praying behind them and they will think it's normal? I ask, did you know a day will come that father and daughter are watching a film, time passes, and they commit zina with each other? I ask, did you know a day will come that when a Muslim is told to hold the Quran in the city center, he will say, brother, my mates are watching me. Don't tell me to hold the Quran. People are going to laugh at me. The girls are going to laugh at me. And when he's told, brother, put it in your bag, he will say, I could not take the risk. Why? Because people are watching me. So one of the brothers puts this Quran, the book of Allah, in the bag for him and he hands it to him and he says, brother, don't give it to me, give it to my mate, he will carry it for me. I asked, did you know these days will come? He sallallahu alayhi wasallam said that time will come that people will be committing sin and all of a sudden people's faces will be transformed into monkeys and pigs. And the same winds that destroyed the people of Lut, the same winds, the same stones will come and destroy these people. The same stones will destroy these people. The same winds that destroyed the people of Ard, the same winds will come and will destroy these people. And the earth will be open and it will take them in and down they'll go. Right till the day of judgment. The day of judgment is close. But in spite of this, we brush it under the table. He sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said that for 40 years, there'll be no iman. Whether it's in Medina, whether it's in Sham, whether it's in Bosnia, whether it's in Chechnya, whether it's in Afghanistan, whether it's in Pakistan, there will be no iman. And then all of a sudden, on a Friday, he sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said that the hour will come